Hi guys, I'm back from the dead. Back in doing the videos now. I'm able to tip my head upside down. I'm happy with it, and I'm still able to get a little bit of work out now with my lungs. So, first one back. Let's go for 5 minutes worth of exercise. We've got three exercises that we're going to go through, and we're going to do it in a Tabata system. So the 20 seconds on, 10 seconds off. So it's a good, nice and easy way for me to start and get back into it. So the first exercise is your static gorilla. There's a lot of different ways that we can do this. Really up to you and your hips and the way that you're feeling as well. I will just let you know that this workout is probably going to work the shoulders a lot, just with the different ways that we're going to be in a prone position. So let's have a look. Static gorilla. What we're wanting to do is get into a gorilla stance. So we know that the gorillas is when we're moving forward. So static meaning we're not going to be moving forward. So our hands are going to be planted down the floor. What we're going to do is we're going to bound back. So our feet are out or like a push-up position. And then we're going to bound in as if we're going to take off. Feet are outside the hands. But then we go back out to push-up position and then back in. So it's kind of like first part or half of the burpee. But this is your static gorilla. Okay, so what I want you to think of though is when we get to this point, I want you to lower the hips down as far as you can without that real pain and grabbing. So make sure that you feel for that for yourself. And then your feet, if they have to point out like mine do, this is the best way for me to get into this position, then I'm gonna do that. You know, we're not all textbook as per in accordance with you know, the textbooks that are out there. Our bodies are different, so just bear in mind with that. So all the way out, bring it back in, and try and lower down the hips as much as you can without feeling too much in the way of pain, but enough that you're getting work in through those hips. Okay, so that's your static gorilla. Now if you're wanting to, you can come here and bring your arms up. Now that just adds another dynamic to it, especially for those that are wanting to work on overhead squats or anything like that, so that we're getting a little bit of range through the thoracic. If we go up like this and we're stuck here, then we've got a bit of work to do. And that's fine, it just lets us know we've got a bit of work to do when it comes to our thoracic mobility and so on. So that's your first exercise, then we rest for 10 seconds, and then your second one is our cobra. So we're in our A-frame position, feet are wide, hands underneath the shoulders, lower down through the middle, we shift to the left or right, shift to the opposite side, back to the middle, and then we're up again. So for those of you, if this is new, if this is as far as you go, this is amazing, this is great, okay, and that's what you want to do. Now I'm going to go kind of side on. You may see is that I want you to at least get some movement in the shoulder blades. See, I drop my body down, I'm going side to side. I haven't even moved my elbows yet, but I've gotten some movement in through the shoulder blades, and that's the important part. So whether it's that shallow or whether it's going deep, okay, whatever it is, you want to make sure that you've got that movement in through there first. Okay, so that's your cobra. 20 seconds, 10 seconds off. And then the last one, we've got a bridge. This one is from the Tibetan Rites. I actually like it. Well, I hate it and I like it. I like it kind of because I hate it. Or I hate it because I like it. One of the two. Like, it's freaking hard. It's a hard exercise. But I find that it's actually really good, especially for shoulders. It really helps us work to open up the chest, lift up the hips, but using the glutes. So we're firing the butt. What we're going to do is we're going to go fingertips pointing to our toes first. Okay, and from here, all we're going to do is we're going to push ourselves, so we lift our hips up, okay, towards the ceiling, and then we're going to pull back and towards, so that our hips are in between the hands. Okay, so lift, and then bring it back in. Up again, lift, and bring it back in. Now for me, lifting my hips up that high is one of my nemesis. So that's why I really love this. It's gonna work my shoulders definitely because it's in a position where I'm actually being made to open up. And we're in a prone, like again, where we're loading these arms. So through all three exercises we're loading through here, and we're asking these shoulders to actually move in all this in different ranges. So yeah, these are the three exercises. I'm gonna go 5 minutes worth. Okay, so we're actually gonna finish off on the leg one, so the gorillas. Today, I know I'm gonna be sweating, I'm probably gonna be coughing in that as well, because this is my first time back, but it's all good in the hood. This is what this is about, right? So we'll see how we go. I'm definitely going to be out of breath as well. I don't have 100% worth function in my lungs, but I do have enough to at least get something going. So if you can go faster than me in the exercise, go faster than me. That's if you really want to get that heart rate going, okay, and you want to push yourself. If you want to stay with me, stay with me. If you're not up to where I will be at, then you just go your own pace as well. Cool? All right, so let's get started. We're in. I'm actually quite excited being back in. Okay. Woo! There it is, starting in 2, 1, and we're on. So, static gorillas. So again, you can go on your pace. If you want to go a bit faster than me, you can go faster. If you're going a little bit slower than me, then that's fine. Either way, you want to try and get the hips lowering down towards the floor. See how my knees are outside my elbows as well, yeah? My feet are outside my hands. I'm allowing my toes to point out too. So it's really up to you and where you want to be with that. Okay, so we're resting for 4, 3, 2, a frame. And then we've got our cobras. So down the middle, side to side, back to the middle, and then up again. So we're going down, side to side, back to the middle, and then up. But remember, your range is your range. And if you want to get heart rate up, just go a bit faster than what I am. And my heart's probably going to get enough of a workout without having to go too fast. But if you want to, go for it. All right, so we'll go for a bridge and a lift. And then we're going to pull all the way back. Then we're going to take off again. So when we come in here, don't stay. Just let the hips go through. And then lift them back up again. Get a bit of a squeeze at the top. Now I hold at the top. Because for me, it's all about giving my glutes, which I do tend to suffer from arse amnesia, which is when my arse forgets to be an arse. It doesn't really do anything, so I like to ask for it. Here we go, static gorillas again. 10 seconds goes really fast, hey? Nice. So with the static gorillas too, I keep my arms straight. So if you're finding that you're bending in your arms, then you're not really kind of utilizing the mechanics that we have with these nice, strong, long arms, and we're using these, we want these shoulders to be nice and strong in that position, right? So don't be afraid to use them. Bending your arms, we're trying to ask for other things to come in, which they need to. This one here, try and get whatever your depth is, and we shift right across as far as we can. But remember, the key is shoulder blades together at the back. Nice. And then my favorite, lifting these ones up. And I see people really high through this, and they get really flat, and I know that I'm not flat, and I'm working on it, and it's all good. Some of you might feel it through shoulders, especially if we're tight through the shoulders as well. So if you need to turn your hands out a little bit, just turn them out slightly. But yeah, we really want to be able to be in this position and still be able to actually get that momentum there, that movement there. So static gorillas. Again, if you want to work on a bit more range in the upper body as well, you can start introducing lifting your arms up. If you're getting stuck here, then that's fine. Just each time, see how far you can go, yeah? Is it nice and controlled? Okay. Cobras again. Here we go. Now with this, try not to drop your hips down when you're pushing up. So make sure your hips are going with you, up and down. It's a little bit harder when you're trying to keep your hips and your shoulders together rather than just dropping your hips and just moving your arms. And move for high. All I'm thinking of is squeezing the glutes, especially at the top. Trying to activate them both as well. My left one is the one that sleeps the most. Not to say my right is any better. but it is very noticeable on my left hand side. And that's cool, it's better than what it was. And that's really all we can ask for, is that every time we go as good as we can at the moment, you know, at the time that we start moving. And we'll notice that our curve is naturally going higher, even if we do drop in a hole like I did last week. Okay? I'm still better off than when I was, let's say a year ago, yeah? So, and that is us done.
Activity completed.
Yay. So, here's a lesson. When your body's telling you to give it a rest, give it a rest. When you can give it a rest, you can come back and look, I gave it a rest for maybe over a week. And I come back and I'm able to do a workout. I sweat, you know, I'm puffing more than I probably would have usually, but even then I would have been able to probably go a little bit faster or harder, which would have got me to the state anyways. So either way, you just work hard to whatever, wherever your body's at, so meet it where it is, hey? So, but yeah, so let me know how that one went. Three exercises, nice and easy. I know the last ones, there were lots of exercises in there. There was actually, you know, it's a good thing because there's a lot that you can learn. You can always pause the videos and play around with them, and then that way, if you've got 15 minutes or 30 minutes, you can actually play around with one of those drills and learn all of those exercises. So there's so much variety that you can do with just a 5-minute video that you get, especially when there are a lot of exercises in there. You can break that out for, you know, 30 minutes and have a really good play. So yeah, let me know how you're going, and I'm back, baby. I'm back in, and let's go for three workouts each week. Yeah, and the more you interact, the more that we'll actually start getting in some new stuff, and I'll be able to give you some things that maybe that you're wanting to revisit or that you'd like to know and things like that. Okay, all right. So see you in the next one. Peace out.